Hi everyone, welcome to my channel Swarna Ma'am's Biology. In this video, I will be explaining you about the nerve impulse and transmission. So let us start. So in our previous videos, we have discussed about the structure of the neuron. So now we will be discussing how the nerve impulse is transmitted from one neuron to another neuron. So here, before going into that, let us introduce the word stimulus. So what is meant by stimulus? It is any change in the external environment that is detectable, we call it as stimulus. It may be of different types. The stimulus is of different types. It may be the increase in temperature, or means it may be the thing which we smell, or it may be because of the thing which we eat, or the sound which we hear, or anything, the hotness which we test, anything which is observed, any change in the environment which is observed, we call it as stimulus. Means it is causing a detectable change in for our cell or a tissue. Any change which is observed, we call it as a stimulus. So when the stimulus is observed, impulse is generated. It has to be carried from that part to the brain, or from the brain again to that part to produce that action. So because of this nerve impulse which is generated, so how the nerve impulse is generated? Because of the stimulus. So this nerve impulse is created mainly by the disturbance of the stimulus. Stimulus has to be detected, and it has to be traveled. Means it the impulse which is generated because of this stimulus has to be traveled or coordinated, and the response has to be given from the brain again. So this neuron, which is mainly involved in the transmission of the nerve impulse, so when it is at rest, so this neuron will be normally negative in charge inside, and outside of the neuron, it will be positive. Means it is at the rest stage. So this neuron, when the action potential is generated because of the stimulus, there occurs depolarization as well as repolarization of the neuron. Then it will be sending the information, and this entire thing, that is the generation of the nerve impulse, is mainly regulated by the sodium and the potassium pump. Now here we have seen the inside neuron is negative charge, outside the neuron is positive charge. So everything I will be explaining now. So mainly the transmission of the nerve impulse mainly involves three steps. Okay, so first step, the neuron will be in the rest phase. So what we call it as polarization state or polarization of the neuron. Then when the impulse is generated, or when the impulse is seen, means when the stimulus is seen and the impulse is generated, the nerve cells get excited. So then next phase is depolarization phase. So it is due to the action potential which has occurred because of this stimulus. So after that, when the nerve impulse is traveling from one part of the neuron to the another, again repolarization of the neuron also occurs. So now we will be discussing each phase in detail. Okay, so here you can see clearly. So I have said that when in the rest phase, that is when the neuron is in the rest phase, outside of the neuron, or this is the axolemma, means axolemma, we have studied what is meant by axolemma. It is the plasma membrane of the axon. So outside of the neuron will be in the positive charge, and the inside of the neuron will be in the negative charge. So in the rest phase, the neuron outside of the neuron, outside the axolemma, will be in the positive, is occupied by the positive ions, and the inside is negative charge. So we will be seeing in our now only in our next slides, why the outside of the neuron is positive and the inside of the neuron is negative. So when the impulse is transmitted from one part of the neuron to the other, there occurs depolarization state. Then later again, there occurs repolarization. Again, the outside becomes positive and inside becomes negative. So here we are observing outside is positive and inside is negative. It is polarization. It is in the rest phase. When the impulse is generated, what The outside will be negative and the inside will be positive, but you can see the next part of the neuron is still in the polarized state. The impulse has to be transmitted from this part to the other. So when the impulse is transmitting, the polarization, depolarization also will be transmitted from one part to the another. So likewise, when it is transmitted from one part of the neuron to the another because of the action potential, after the transmission of the nerve impulse, then again repolarization occurs, where again the positive charge will be coming outside and the negative charge will be coming inside. So why this is occurring, we will be seeing now. So first, the generation of the nerve impulse. Whenever the stimulus is seen, there will be a generation of the nerve impulse. So during the generation of the nerve impulse, first, in the first phase, we have seen the nerve, that is axolemma, will be in the rest phase. So whenever in the polarized state or in the rest state, sodium channels will be closed. Why the outside of the axolemma is positive and inside of the axolemma is a negative? Why? Because the sodium channels in the resting phase will be closed. So what happens when the sodium channels are closed? There will be, these are the sodium ions, which is making the outside of the axolemma positive and the inside of the axolemma to be negative. So during the rest phase, the sodium ions are not allowed to go inside the axon. So then the outside of the axon will be positive and the inside of the axon will be negative. We call this phase as polarized phase, and the resting potential is about -70 MV. Here we have seen the sodium channels are closed. So the sodium ions are not passing from the outside of the axolemma into the inside the axolemma. Inside the axolemma, there will be potassium ions along with the negative protein. Because of that, the negative charge is occupied by the inside of the axolemma. So here we have to remember, during the rest phase, sodium ions are sodium channels are closed. So when the sodium channels are closed, these are not passing through the axolemma. So when they are not passing through the axolemma, here only potassium ions are present along with the negative protein. So causing the inside negative charge and outside positive charge, these sodium ions are not coming inside. So because of that, polarized state is seen in the case of resting fiber. Okay, there is no entry of sodium ions. So now when the impulse is generated, why? Because of the stimulus, then the sodium channels open. When the sodium channels are opening, the sodium ions from outside are entering inside the axolemma. So here we are seeing, when the impulse is generated, sodium channels are open, allowing the sodium ions to pass through the sodium channel inside the axon. So positive ions are entering inside. Okay, so now what causes? It causes depolarization. So because of the entry of the sodium ions, due to the excitation of the nerve fiber, there occurs what is called as depolarization. Okay, so there is occurring a state which is called as depolarization, where sodium ions are entering into the axon. Okay, so potassium ions are still present. Now, because of this depolarized state, we know that there must be a balance in the ions, that is, sodium ions and the potassium ions has to be balanced. So in the first phase, that is, when in the resting phase, we know the outside of the axolemma is what? The outside of, because means in the resting phase, we know that outside is positive and inside is negative. On receiving the stimulus, that sodium ions are entering into the axon. So what is happening? The positive ions, here we can see the positive ions are moving inside. These positive ions are moving inside. inside already there are potassium ions. So there is imbalance in the ions. So now what has to be done? This potassium ions has to move out. So this phase where the sodium ions are entering inside, we call it as depolarized phase. Okay. So where here we know that sodium ions, sodium channels are open and the action potential is about minus 55 MV. So let us take a small concept test before going into the third. Is said to be in the polarized state. When the nerve cell is said to be in the polarized state, action potential, resting stage, depolarization, repolarization. So when the nerve cell is said to be in the polarized state, that is outside positive and inside negative, it is only during the resting phase. So the correct answer is resting stage. Yes. So let us go into the conduction of the nerve impulse. So now we have seen the nerve impulse is generated and depolarization is happening. Why? Because the sodium ions are entering through the sodium channels and entering inside. So the nerve, that is now the axon is depolarized state. Now this impulse has to be conducted. Now, here again we are repeating at the start of the resting phase, the nerve is completely polarized where the sodium ions are outside and potassium ions are inside, which is making the axon to be polarized. When the action potential is initiated because of the stimulus, the membrane repolarizes. As a result, adjacent becomes depolarized. So here, when the stimulus is generated, what happens? Here we know that sodium ions are entering inside. I will write with another pen. So the sodium ions are entering inside. Yes. Up to here will be depolarized. It will be in the depolarized state. But the adjacent part is still polarized only. Okay. So when the nerve impulse is transmitting from like this, from one part to the another, depolarization also pass from one part of the axon to the next. Okay, so here the sodium ions are entering inside. When the sodium ions are entering, what is happening? Here the negative charge comes. Okay, so what we call it as passive depolarization. So when the nerve impulse is spreading one part of the axon to the next, depolarization also spreads. Why? Sodium ions are entering slowly inside, which is making the outside negative. Okay, slowly the depolarization is spreading because of the entry of the sodium ions inside. Here the sodium ions are entering inside. When the sodium ions are entering inside, it has to be maintained. The ions has to be maintained in balance. So what happens? There will be passing of potassium ions to outside. So for the entry of three sodium ions, there will be entry of two potassium ions. Means when three sodium ions are taken in, two potassium ions are given out. So outside, so this depolarized phase, we can see the outside part of axolemma will be in the negative stage, whereas the inside part will be in the positive charge. So what we call it as depolarization, and it spreads from one part of the axon to the another. So now, when the adjacent region is depolarized to its threshold, the action potential also spreads from one part to the another. Now, again, after the spreading of the depolarization from one part to the another, only up to the threshold, that is maximum level, repolarization happens. We have seen repolarization happens because of the passage of the potassium ions again to outside. So potassium ions outflow the means the outward flow of the potassium ions makes the axon again to repolarize. Again to repolarize. Repolarize happened due to the outward flow of potassium ions When the depolarization is spreading or triggering due to the action potential. So when we can see sodium ions are entering inside, here the negative charge is there. So it is spreading from one part of the axon to the another. So immediately what happens? The potassium ions which are present here goes out, okay, which causes repolarization. Okay, so here we can see the potassium ions are moving out here. See, potassium ions are moving out, which causes repolarization of this part which has been depolarized. Okay. So this depolarization spread forward, repeating process. So here we can see when the sodium ions are coming inside, inside of the axillary becomes positive and outside becomes negative. To balance that, again the potassium ions are moving out to make it positive. So which we call it as repolarization. Okay. So it will be spreading from one part of the axon to the another because of the transmission of this impulse. So during the depolarization, means when the sodium ions are entering in, why they are entering in? Mainly because the sodium channels are open. At that time, the potassium ion channels are closed. Immediately, to balance the negative and positive charge across the axillary, now repolarization occurs, causing the closure of the sodium channels and opening of the potassium channels. Okay. So here we can clearly see. So at first, in the resting phase, inside of the axillary is negative and outside is positive. Why? Outside is occupied by the sodium ions and inside the axillary is occupied by the potassium ions along with the negative protein. Okay. It is in the resting phase. So when the impulse is generated, the sodium ions outside enter inside the axon. Why? Because of the opening of the sodium channels. So when the sodium channels open, the sodium ions which are present outside now enter into the axon. So when the sodium ions are entering inside, the outside becomes negative. What we are calling it as depolarization. Because of the excitation of the neuron, what is called as depolarization. This depolarization is spreading from one part of the axon to the another. So this is spreading from one part to the another, where up to here, we can see when the impulse is transmitted to here, the sodium ions are entering from the outside of the axon to inside. So this stimulus, but the impulse which is required for the opening of the sodium channels and entering of the sodium ions from outside to inside, that potential we call it as action potential. Okay, and the impulse because this action potential is transmitted from one part of the axon to the another. So here, during this depolarization phase, what we will be observing, sodium channels are open and potassium channels are closed. So when we spread from one part to the axon to the next, now, again, that is when the action potential is spread from one part to the next, now the sodium channels are closed and potassium channels are open, making the potassium ions to be sent out to balance the number of the charges outside and inside, which again causes repolarization because of the potassium ions which are moving outside. Okay, so here we can see sodium ions are entering in and to balance the potassium ions are moving out. Okay. So here we can easily observe. So here the sodium ions are entering in. So here it is depolarization. So again, repolarization occurs because of the opening of the potassium ions and they are entering outside. Okay. So what is meant by saltatory conduction? So of the nerve impulse along a neuron, means the connection of the nerve impulse along a myelinated neuron, where the impulse is jumped from one node of Raniver to another. So what is meant by, we know what is meant by nodes of Raniver. Yes, we have seen. So nodes of Raniver means, so the places, so if it is the axon, what is what are the nodes of Raniver? We have already discussed these places. We call it as nodes of Raniver. Okay. So when the impulse is jumped from one nodes of Raniver, one node of Raniver to the another, we call it as salt artery conduction. Okay. So here, the transmission of the nerve impulse is faster. So now let us take a small concept test. So during the repolarization, the potassium ion channels, so we have seen during the depolarization, sodium ion channels are closed. Now during the repolarization, what has to occur? The potassium ion channels has to open. Then only the, during the depolarization, because of the entry of the sodium ions inside the nerve, that is the axon, there is depolarized. So to balance the polarity of the axon outside and inside, now the potassium ions has to move out. So what happens? The potassium ion channels has to open to balance the number of the sodium ions. For 3 sodium ions entering in, 2 potassium ions has to go out. Okay. So here in our question, during the repolarization, the potassium ion channels open. Then only the polarization will be balanced, that is repolarization occurs. So here the correct answer is opens. During the depolarization, potassium ion channels closes, whereas during repolarization, the potassium ion channels opens. Okay. Now, so we have seen the impulse is generated and has to be transmitted from one neuron to the another. Here, this is one neuron. We have to consider this person as one neuron and it has to be transmitted to the another neuron. To now, we have seen how it is transmitted, conduction of the nerve impulse in that neuron from one part of the axon to the another. So it has to be transmitted. There are so many neurons in our body. So the nerve impulse has to be transmitted from one neuron to the another neuron, means from that part of the organ to the brain, and from the brain again the impulse has to be generated to the receptor organ. Here the nerve impulse, it has to be transmitted from one neuron to the another neuron. So that neuron which is sending the impulse is presynaptic neuron, and the nerve a neuron which is receiving the impulse, we call it as postsynaptic neuron. So here the nerve impulse is transmitted from one neuron to another. So the before neuron we are calling it as presynaptic neuron, and the impulse is transmitted to the neuron that is postsynaptic neuron. Here correctly we can say that the teledendrites of the presynaptic neuron transmits the impulse through the dendrites of the postsynaptic neuron. Okay. Is the transmitting of the impulse from one neuron to another neuron. In between the two neurons, there is a place where the nerve impulse is transmitted, which we call it as synapse. When we see the synapse, there are two types of the synapses. This is electrical synapse as well as chemical synapse. So when we see the electrical synapse, here the excitation, that is conduction of the excitation or the transmission of the impulse is through the ions. Okay. And here in the chemical synapse, it is the transmission of the nerve impulse is because of some neurotransmitter which is transmitted from the presynaptic neuron to the another. Here when we see the electrical synapse, here both the presynaptic neuron as well as postsynaptic neuron are very close to one another. Okay, there is no need of neurotransmitter. So where the nerve impulse from the presynaptic neuron is directly transmitted to the postsynaptic neuron, here you can see There is a presynaptic neuron. It is the receiver prosynaptic neuron. There are no neurotransmitter. It is directly transmitted through the gap junction. Here, the electric synapse are very fast. Okay, so here there is no neurotransmitter. But in the case of the chemical synapse, the postsynaptic neuron, which is receiving the impulse, there will be the neurotransmitters which are present, which transmit the impulse from one. But this presynaptic neuron to postsynaptic neuron. Here, what we can say, the membranes of both post and presynaptic neuron are separated by the synaptic cleft. Okay, and these chemical synapses are very fast, and there is neurotransmitter which is involved. Here, these are the synaptic vesicles which will be receiving the impulses, and there will be the neurotransmitters which is present in the postsynaptic neuron, that is receiving cell, which receives the messages which is sent by this synaptic vesicle, and they transmit the impulse to the next neuron. So here we can see these are all the synaptic vesicles. So that is axon. When we see the axon terminal, we can see the synaptic vesicles in the presynaptic neuron, which is receiving the impulse. And this message or the impulse, which will be released into the presynaptic membrane, and it will be released into the synaptic cleft. And it will be received by the receptor of the postsynaptic membrane. Okay, so now here we can say that the neurotransmitters are mainly responsible. So these are the neurotransmitters. The neurotransmitters are mainly responsible for the transmission of impulse from one neuron to another. These neurotransmitters, which are carried by the synaptic vesicles, when they are released in the presynaptic, that is synaptic cleft from the presynaptic neuron, which will be received by the receptors of the postsynaptic neuron, and will be here. We can even draw here, which will be received. This is a postsynaptic neuron. This is the axon terminal of the postsynaptic neuron. So these are the receptors. So the nerve impulse, which is transmitted from this presynaptic neuron in the form of neurotransmitters, they are released into the vesicles and they are received by the receptors of the postsynaptic neuron. Now they are transmitted to this. So if this is the neuron, okay, this is the presynaptic neuron, okay. So this part is drawn here, okay? So this part, this is an axon terminal. So here, another neuron, postsynaptic neuron is there. So this junction, we are calling it as synaptic cleft. So here, the neurotransmitters are sending the messages and which is received by the postsynaptic neuron, and it will be again passed to the entire neuron. So this is the presynaptic neuron axon terminal, and the neurotransmitters are transmitting the impulse which is released in the synaptic cleft, which is received by the postsynaptic neuron, that is dendrites of the postsynaptic neuron. Okay, so the junction between the presynaptic neuron as well as postsynaptic neuron, we call it as synapse. Okay, so here we can see the neurotransmitters of the presynaptic neuron are released and they are received by the receptors of the postsynaptic neuron, and the impulse is transmitted. Okay, hope you are clear. Now let us take a small concept test. The gap between the two neuron, what we call it as? It is synapse or synapses. Okay. So let us summarize. The neurons are excitable cells because their membranes are always in the polarized state. Okay. The outside we have seen, outside the axilemma, it is positive, and inside it is negative in the resting phase. When depolarization occurs, then again repolarization also occurs. The neurons are excitable because the membranes are always in the polarized state. So means outside is positive and inside is negative because of sodium and potassium ions. Different types of the ion channels are present on the neural membrane. These channels are selectively permeable to different ions, that is sodium ions and potassium ions, depending upon the excitability of the neuron. A nerve, when it is stimulated, usually at one point, and then it is propagated along the entire neuron. When the neuron is not conductive, the nerve conducting the nerve impulse, it is said to be in the resting potential. In the resting potential, what happens? The outside of the axon is occupied by the sodium ion, and inside it is occupied by the potassium ion and a negatively charged protein. Because of this, during the resting phase, the axonema will be positively charged outside and negatively charged inside. What we call it as polarized state. The nerve cell, when it is receiving the stimulus, the nerve impulse is generated, then which is followed by the transmission of this nerve impulse when it is said to be action potential. This sodium ion and potassium ion both move in opposite directions to generate a potential difference along the axon. Okay? The axon membrane is comparatively more permeable to the potassium ions and nearly impermeable to the sodium ions. Similarly, the membrane is impermeable to the negatively charged proteins present in the axoplasm. Okay. The axoplasm inside the axon contains more amount of the potassium ions and negatively charged protein and low concentration of sodium ions. In contrast, the fluid outside the axon has low concentration of the potassium ion and high concentration of the sodium ions, which forms a concentration gradient. These ionic gradients across the resting membrane are maintained by the active transport of the both the sodium as well as potassium ions. As we have seen, for two potassium ions, three sodium ions will be transported. Okay? During the action potential, due to the difference in the concentration across the membrane, there is a movement of the ion through the sodium and the potassium gates. This leads to the rapid influx of the sodium followed by the reversal of the polarity at that side, what we call it as depolarization. This polarity of that membrane at that side has to be again repolarized. So now what happens? This potassium ions will be moved outside because of the opening of the potassium channels, which makes the axon again to be repolarized. Okay. And we have seen when the impulse is generated, it has to be jumped from one node of ANIVA to the another. Okay. And which we call it as saltatory conduction. Yes, this is about the entire thing about the nerve impulse and transmission. Hope you understood this topic. If you like this topic, please like my video, share and subscribe my channel, Swarna Ma'am's Biology. Meet you with the next topic in the next video. Until then, thank you.